हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर चैप्टर नंबर 24 मेजर्स ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी. वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट मीन, मीडियन, क्वार्टाइल्स एंड मोड. देर आर मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ स्टैटिकल एवरेजेस. आउट ऑफ दम फॉर यू ओनली द फ्यू एवरेजेस. वन इज अरिथमेटिक एवरेज और मीन, सेकेंड वन मीडियन, थर्ड वन इज मोड. इन दिस चैप्टर यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न दीज थ्री in these different datas. First one is raw data. Raw data means the numbers. It is not arranged in ascending or descending order. The numbers are shuffled, like example 1, 5, 6, 3, 5, 7, 5, 2, 5, and some numbers. This is called the raw data. It is not arranged in ascending or descending order, not in order also. This is called raw data. Now for this, you are going to find the mean, median, mode. Now, mean of n numbers. The formula is sum of n observations divided by number of observations. That is sigma x by n. Sigma x represent, these are x. So, now you are adding sigma represent, this is called sigma, this sign. And sigma is sum of the numbers represent by this symbol sigma. Sigma x by n, you are adding all the number and divide by number of numbers. Now there are 10 numbers are there. So adding 1 plus 5 plus 6 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 5 plus 2 plus 5 plus 10 by 10. 49 is the total divided by 10. 4.9 is the mean. Now come to mode. What is mode? Mode is a value which occurs most frequently in a set of observation. These are called the observation. In that, which number coming frequently or again and again and many times, that is the mode. Here in this, which number repeating? 5 is repeating many times. Therefore, the mode is equal to 5. The third one is median. Median is the value of middle term of a set of numbers or variables when the variables are arranged in ascending or descending order. See, all the other two, mode and mean, not necessary to arrange the numbers. For median, you have to arrange the numbers in ascending order or descending order, and you have to find the middle term. First, arrange the given terms in ascending order. The same example I am taking, arrange the numbers 1, 2, 3, 5, 5, 5, 5, 6, 7, 10. This here 4, here 4, the middle are 2, 5s are there. These are the two terms or the middle terms. So adding these two and divide by 2, you are getting the median. So 5 plus 5, 10 divided by 2. Here the number is, how many numbers are there? 10. So now if it is even, the formula is the average of n by 2th term plus n by 2 plus 1th term. So, what is median if the numbers are even? N by 2th term plus n by 2 plus 1th term divided by 2. N by 2 means there are 10 numbers. 10 by 2, 5th term, and next term, 6th term. 5th and 6th term you are adding and divide by 2, you are getting the median. Suppose the number of terms is odd. Example I took 1, 2, 5, 7, 10. There are 5 numbers are there. 5 is odd. So, the formula is n plus 1 by 2. Middle term you are going to find out. So 5 plus 1 6, 6 by 2, 6 by 2. Third term is median, which is the third term. 1 2 5 is the third term. Therefore 5 is the median. So now you have to remember, note that also I gave, if the number of terms even, then the median is half of n by 2th term plus n by 2 plus 1th term. That means n by 2th term plus next term, add it and divide by 2. If the number of terms are odd, then median is equal to n plus 1 by 2th term. Now, all you understood for the raw data, what is mean, what is median, and what is mode. Now, take for the tabulated data. Tabulated data, now you are giving the numbers and you have to find out. First, I explain everything and then I will give the. So, this is called the tabulated form. 5. 15, 25, 35, 45. This is the value of x. Frequency 14, 16, 20, 30, 20. These are the frequency. So these are the called the tabulated form. The x values are given, frequency value given. Now you are going to find the mean, median and mode. Now mean formula, this is always the mean represented by x bar is equal to sigma fx divided by sigma f. Sigma represents sum of. Now first you have to find the fx. 14 into 5 is 70, 16, 15 are 240, 25 into 25, 100, 35 into 30, 1050, 45 into 20, you are getting 890. Now you are getting, adding everything, you are getting, how much you are getting? The sigma represents sum of the frequency, adding the frequency, you are getting 100, all the frequency you are adding, total frequency 100, sigma fx 2750. So, what is the tabulated form? Mean is equal to x bar is equal to sigma fx divided by sigma f 2750 by 127.5. This is also called the direct method. Next, come to the mode. What is mode? The observation opposite to highest frequency. In frequency, which is the highest frequency? 30 is the highest frequency. Opposite to 30, what is the observation? 35. Therefore, 35 is the mode. Mode is 35, highest frequency 30, opposite to 35. What is the observation? That is called mode. There here, 35 is the mode. Now, come for the median. The same example. Now one more example, also simple example I took for you. Okay. Now, the x values 5, 15, 25, 35, 45. The frequencies are 14, 16, 20, 30, 20. Now, add it. You are getting sigma f is equal to 100. All you, now in the previous chapter, you learned how to find the cumulative frequency. First, 14. 14 plus 16, 30. 30 plus 20, 50. 50 plus 30, 80. 80 plus 20, 100. 100 represented by n. N is equal to sigma f is equal to 100. These two values will be same always. So the last cumulative frequency is equal to sigma f, that is n. Okay. Now what is this 14 represent? This is 1 to 14th term. What is this 30 after 14? 15. So 15 to 30th term. See, our 14 terms, the first 14 terms are 5. 15th term to 30th term 15. Then 31 term to 50th term 25, 51 term to 80th term 35, 81 to 100th term 45. This is represented by cumulative frequency. That is why I wrote it here. So 14, 1 to 14, 30, 15 to 30, you have to write it, then you can easily remember. Here n is equal to 100. 100 is even. To find the median, what is the formula? Half of n by 2th term plus n by 2 plus 1th term. Here n is 100. 100 by 2 is 50. Next term is 51. So 50th term plus 51 term divided by 2. Now go here. 50th term, where it is? Here. Opposite to 50 term, the number is 25. 51th term is 35. Therefore, half into 25 plus 35 is equal to half of 60, 30. Therefore, 30 is the median. If it is odd mean, then median is equal to half of n plus 1. N plus 1 by 2th term or half of n plus 1. Now, you have to remember finding the mean by other two methods. There are two more methods are there to find the mean. One is shortcut method. Second one is step deviation method. And that is called the direct method. Now, shortcut method. Now, I'm going to explain the shortcut method. There are three formula. One is shortcut method. Second one is step deviation. Third, the normal method or direct method. Already I taught you x bar is equal to sigma fx by sigma f. This is the direct method. Now, come for the shortcut method. Mean is equal to a plus sigma fd divided by sigma f. A is called the assumed mean. We have to assume some mean. D represents deviation. X minus A. X represents the middle value or the observation minus A. F represents frequency. Sigma F represents sum of frequencies. Sigma FD represents sum of FD. and x is the mid value or observation. Next method is step deviation method. Mean, the formula is a plus sigma f t divided by sigma f into I. Here a represent assumed mean, t is also deviation. Now a little difference, x minus a is d, okay, divided by I, d by I is t. Then x is the mid value. I represent the class size, upper limit minus lower limit, or the difference between the two class mark. Then is equal to x. So now by using the formula, x bar is equal to a plus sigma f t by sigma f into I. This method is called the step deviation, and this method is called the shortcut, and this method is called the direct method. Now I am going to take an example, and I am going to solve all the three methods, that is the direct method, shortcut and step deviation. Example, x value 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. This is the tabulated form. Only the numbers are the x value given. Then it is called the tabulated form, and the frequencies are 5, 8, 4, 3, 5. Direct method, the formula is sigma fx divided by sigma f. So you are finding fx. Adding f, you are getting 25. Adding fx, you are getting 700. Mean is equal to 700 by 25. Is 28. Now for the shortcut method, x you are writing, frequency, these two are given in the question. Now in x, which is the middle value? 30. So always you have to choose the assumed mean from the value of x, that is the middle value of x. Here a 30, suppose it is the even, you can, two middle value will be there, any one you can take. So assumed mean you are taking is 30. Then the column D represent x minus a. X is the column. From that you are going to subtract the assumed mean. That is 10 minus 30 is minus 20. 20 minus 30 is minus 10. 30 minus 30 is 0. 40 minus 30 is 10. 50 minus 40 is 20. D is equal to x minus a. A is the assumed mean you are going to take from the mid value of x column. Now next you are going to find the FD, F into D, 5 into minus 20 minus 100, 8 into minus 10 is equal to minus 80, 4 into 0, 0, 3 into 10, 30, 5 into 20, 100, and this is FD. So you are going to calculate sigma F is 25, sigma FD adding, you are getting minus 50 sigma FD. Now, the shortcut method formula, mean, that is x bar is equal to a plus sigma fd divided by sigma f. A represent the assumed mean you are taking from the middle value of x, that is 30, plus sigma fd is minus 50 divided by sigma f 25. So, what you are getting? 30 minus 2. You are cancelling 50 and you are getting, so you are getting 30 minus 2 is equal to 28. So, A represent the assumed mean from the value of x. Your frequency, the deviation is x minus a. Now, the third method, step deviation method. Step deviation method, same question, x column, frequency column. Now, from the middle value of x, you are taking a is equal to 30. What is I? I is the class mark or mid value, upper limit minus lower limit, or the difference between the middle value. So you can take 20 minus 10 is 10, or 30 minus 20, or 40 minus 30, 50 minus, you are getting 10. This represents I. The column T is equal to x minus a by I. X is 30, you are taking, a is assumed to mean 30, these are the x column. So, 10 minus 30, I is 10, divide by 10, you are getting minus 2. Next to 20 minus 30, minus 10, minus 10 by 10, minus 1. 30 minus 30, 0. 40 minus 30 by 10, 1. 50 minus 30, you are getting 2. So, these are the T value. Now, you are going to calculate FT. This T and F you are multiplying. 5 into minus 2, minus 10, 8 into minus 1, minus 8, 4 into 0, 0, 3 into 1, 3, 5 into 2, 10. calculate sigma f t, that is adding sigma f. You are getting sigma f t is minus 5 and sigma f is 25. What is the formula? X bar mean is equal to a plus sigma f t by sigma f into I. A plus 30 assumed mean plus minus 5 by 25 into 10. Within the bracket, you write, first you have to calculate this value. You are getting minus 2. 30 minus 2 is equal to 28. This is this mean by step deviation method. Now, I taught you by the tabulation form how to calculate mean by all the three methods. All of you see your exercise and do these sums. Next video, I will explain you the grouped data, how to find mean, median and mode. So, practice all the sums from the exercise. Thank you.